Greetings, Eric Bakker. Thanks for tuning in. Give me some feedback. I've got a new computer, bigger screen basically, and I just want to know that if these videos are okay, if you can hear me fine and you can see me fine. I just make them in one take and put them up on the internet, so I don't really sort of understand on the quality of them. So yeah, if the quality's not good, please let me know. I have got a interesting comment here from a subscriber called Kate Sand. The spit test is accurate. I hate to disagree with you. I've been to 3 GI doctors with no success. They tell me I have anxiety, lol. I've constant headaches, sinus issues, nausea, body aches, mood swings, irritability, and constipation. I've been to the top GI doctors in the USA. I've had 2 endoscopies, 1 sigmoidoscopy, 2 stool analysis, breath tests, thousands of blood tests. Wow. I always knew something because my saliva was never thick. I did the spit test and sure enough, candida or yeast overgrowth. I cut out sugar and I'm experiencing probably the die-off symptoms. I feel like screaming from discomfort. I will take oregano oil to see what happens. I'm tired of doctor's appointments. Well, Kate, I'm sorry to disagree with you, but the spit test is not always accurate. In fact, on many occasions now, particularly the last, I would say, 12 months, I've had several people who've had their spit analyzed, you know, by different labs. And some of these labs are quite credible. In fact, highly credible labs. And the reports came back that they couldn't find any bad bacteria, no fungus, no yeast, nothing. And these are people with stringing, hanging down, you know, chunks of mucus and phlegm in the glass of water. I have had other people who, like you, swear that they've got a problem there with candida because of the spit. And they later on found out, in fact, that they had a pancreatic problem. They didn't have a spit problem at all. They had an issue with breaking down starches properly, you know, in the upper part of the digestive tract. So the body made lots and lots of stringy mucus. So what I'm starting to discover, many people with a spit issue, in fact, haven't really got a spit issue, a candida issue as such. They've got a digestive problem. And often the enzymes will need fixing up. So people now who've got, for example, a very low pancreatic elastase marker, which you can easily get done, if you've got any kind of weird spit problems and you've got a low PE1 level, get the pancreas fixed. We'll improve its function by taking some enzymes. Enzymes can really affect that spit test significantly. And that's the other problem, is people taking dietary supplements. You know, before or around doing that spit test, even probiotics can affect the spit test. So you need to be careful making assumptions, because you make an assumption, you make out of, well, you should know that one anyway. So thousands of blood tests later, and you still don't know what's wrong. You've been to all the top GI doctors. I wonder what's going on. Maybe you want to go to a non-top GI doctor and go maybe to a bottom GI doctor or something like that. I don't know what the solution is, but go and find a lady or a guy who can do a stool test to help you out. And maybe then you can see the true extent of what's really going on in the tummy, all right? And then you don't have to have high anxiety anymore. Thanks for your question, Kate. Do the stool test.